It. I see you, Miss Harris, spoofing off on Twitter about NIDS.
Yes.
Some for, some against, some saying there's not enough information to make a decision as to whether they are for or against. What is the opposition doing now?
They're making a last minute appeal to the government to reconsider making into law the National Identification and Registration Bill, despite the legislation being on the verge of being signed by the Governor General.
You know more about this than I do. I mean, I think you're more up on it than I am.
And I still don't think I know enough.
Tell me
what
you want
to know. Part of the challenge is people think when people voice their concern about NIDS, they're saying not to do NIDS. And that's two totally different types of discussion. I think people understand that NIDS may be important, but that there is a way to get it done. And I think a little bit later on when we speak to our cybersecurity guests, people get a better understanding of why there are concerns. I still think there needed to be more public awareness. And I know people are going to tell me it was on all the talk shows and it was in traditional media, but there are people in this country that are not watching television or listening to radio 24 hours a day. So you can place 20 ads and them still don't hear it.
Yeah.
You know?
This is underground consultation.
Absolutely.
Community consultation.
I believe the same way we feel it is important to knock from door to door to get a vote during election time when we have matters of national importance. We must do that knocking from door to door and dropping of the pamphlet into the mailbox so everybody has time to read it and absorb it and understand what it is.
I actually think you're right.
NIDS is
too important.
And for the folks
who can't read it, then you can tell them what it's about.
Someone NIDS is too important.
Yeah.
And clearly there is not enough information, because when you hear people start talking about all kind of things, then you say, okay,
they're
not understanding. It means they're not understanding it. So.
Well, the PNP's NEC at a meeting at the Manchester High School on the weekend says that it strongly supports a position taken by the opposition. They're calling on the Prime Minister to return to what they call the deeply flawed bill, take it back to Parliament for referral to a joint parliamentary committee for review. They are taking issue with clauses that were agreed in the House of Representatives but reintroduced and approved in the Senate. So they're not happy about that. So they want more consultation, more stakeholder groups to make a determination about how that bill moves forward. But as you said, isn't it as good as passed?
Well, that's another thing, because some things I don't understand how they operate in this country now. Because I thought the Governor General was supposed to be that midpoint of reason. But clearly, if the ruling party says sign it, he has to sign it. Maybe I'm wrong. Somebody can correct me. But if the opposition says, no, we don't agree, I thought he was the place that that both parties could meet for some kind of discussion, like a mediator or something. I didn't know King's House was just there.
Well,
maybe I'm wrong. Somebody can correct me. I don't know.
If not, then somebody can tell us.
Yeah.
But really, but that again just goes to show that more disclosure.
Yeah, man. And civil society groups are not happy. And when people are not, it's a democracy, you know. It's a democracy. And even if it's right, it's important to get buy-in from everyone.
Because that's how it works.
Absolutely.
And
if everyone agree, well, we have to find a way to you know what I mean?
Yeah. Because everybody will not agree, but if there's a difference when people feel like they're
them understand and you listen to them.
And you listen to
In
the meantime, though, the Prime Minister is... this is the same story. All right.
Yeah.
So we can leave that alone. That's where it is now. We don't know what's going to happen from here, but it seems like NIDS is a go.
It's a go.
Hearing, so.
It seems like it's a go, but I'm still appealing for better public awareness.
All right. A move, a very bold move being taken in St. Lucia. The St. Lucian government says it's undertaking a campaign that is aimed at discontinuing the sale of soft drinks in schools.
That's interesting.
We have a campaign running, Jamaica Moves, and lately I've been hearing commercials talking about how much sugar you consume and how that can make you sick. I've also heard discussion about this happening in Jamaica, or just like an increased tax on sugar drinks to reduce sugar consumption. Yeah, but you know,
here data goes again.
Tell me.
Part of the argument from persons who consume these drinks comes down to the economy of it.
Cheap.
When I walk into one of these restaurants or fast food places and I ask for a drink, the drink that is healthiest is extremely expensive mm-hmm. in comparison to the one that maybe a lot of people can afford.
That's why bag juice is so popular.
Yeah, so it's one thing to say to people, don't drink it, but now come government, how do we help them to afford
something that is healthier?
Yes.
Okay.
And this says highly sweetened fizzy drink is known to have disastrous effects. It said it's diabetes, heart disease, obesity, asthma, cavities, mm-hmm. among other illnesses.
Mm-hmm.
So the chief nutritionist says she's met with school principals to discuss the best way to reduce the consumption of soda among the youth. Mm.
Well, that's an
interesting
first step. I think that's the first region I've heard of, too.
I don't think it's going to happen, but let's see.
You don't think it'll happen?
No. I think the soda people have too much money.
Well, then this may force them to create a healthier alternative.
The soda people?
So in the States, they're doing it. They've provided different options. So people who want the regular soda can drink it. Then you have like a half sugar, then a quarter sugar reduced, then a diet.
But that's in the States
option.
Where the market, where the competitive nature of the market
forces them to do that. Maybe those variants can come here and give people options.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
But then there's some
nutritionists who will
if you drink the diet soda, better you drink the regular soda because the fake sugar in the diet soda, that's part of me or whatever it is, it is worse than the regular sugar. So, you know, you do just drink some water. And call it George. So not the best plan to me.
Well, have mercy. Right. This one warms the cockles.
Of course it would.
Real lives of royalty. God bless their...
I hope they don't do a show.
God bless them in their little cotton socks.
I hope they don't do a show.
Prince Harry is engaged to Meghan Markle. Isn't that
so
amazing?
Did you know who Meghan Markle was before you heard
I
you?
Watched her in Suits.
Of course you did.
I watched her in
Suits.
Oh, you
watch every show?
Yeah.
So you and Carol Beckford are very happy?
I'm very happy because Prince Harry has always been that royal that just...
He's the coolest dude ever.
That is just Prince Harry. Prince Harry not trying nothing else. But Prince Harry, me think if them say, stop being you or we're going to give the crown, Prince Harry would say, I'm
keep
cool
it.
With that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that he followed his heart and is marrying Meghan is true to Prince Harry, and I am over the moon.
Are you going to the wedding?
You know, I'm expecting an invite from Meghan.
Because you don't know how to...
But they're under a lot of pressure. They're under a lot of pressure. Will and Kate had me on the list. I said, guys, I know it's a lot of pressure. If I don't come, it's cool by me. I'll step back so you can invite someone else. So, if I don't make it, I'm not going to be hurt. I'm not going to be hurt. Because I'll be at the pre-wedding events, which are really much more intimate. No. Those things are from the Queen's list, you know? So they have to invite the royal people and the whole heap of people. The little intimate things for friends that are close. Yeah.
Okay.
Speaking about friends, do we have any more hot topics?
Wait, no. So tell me a little bit about Meghan now. So Meghan is half black. Half,
yes.
She's into what is it? Politically correct term. She's mixed.
Mixed race.
A mixed heritage. Mm-hmm. I think her mom is actually African American and dreadlocked, and her dad, I think, is Caucasian. Mm. So that's another thing that has a... You know, the royal folks in uproar that, you know, Harry is marrying a black girl. And, oh, that will change it.
Look it.
It's really a big thing him doing.
If they do the DNA of a lot of those people in Europe,
girl,
I don't know how to tell them that black is going to pop up.
Into foreign too?
Into a lot of
foreign
DNA.
Foreign. Okay.
So it's okay. It was bound to happen. It is what it is. I was going to say, speaking of good friends, I saw a lady on the weekend and she said, Delia, Marvin Vex, when you trouble him a morning time? And I said, how could he be? Unless he's offended by the truth. But everything I say about Marvin is true.
And Harrow.
So if he's vexed.
And Aubrey.
Oh, I wouldn't tell a lie on Harrow. Aubrey, sometimes I tell a lie on Aubrey. Me admit that. Because I know him wife and she's a good soul.
Did you
soul.
Hear this lady? See, this.
She's a good soul.
This. So,
no, when me tell lie, I want up some me tell lie.
No, Talia. So no.
Tell
no. Hold on.
Me not tell lie on Harrow. But Marvin, see, everything me talk about Marvin is true.
Jesus. Did you just admit that you lied about something with Aubrey?
Aubrey. Anything I lie about, I own
okay,
it.
Okay, hold on. So can we bring you a little bit closer? Can you just tell the truth that you didn't really order anything for me and that there's nothing
Simone, let me tell you something.
Since you took that very bold step.
Somebody give Simone something. Me and say, Arrow, I'm them in a complaints. I say, Mister, but me telling you, say, Simone ungrateful. You can't get Simone ungrateful. Me, I tell you, me never see somebody ungrateful like Simone. But can we say happy birthday? Me just want to say happy birthday because God knows Simone. Yeah, thank you very much. Play the theme music.
Really? Okay.
I want to say happy birthday to Lisa James Brown.
Is it even her birthday today?
It Lyle? Is Lisa James
Come on.
Brown's
Come in
birthday. I also want to say happy birthday to Gaia Budai, Marvin Campbell, Ricardo Blackwood,
my
wonderful nutritionist Joy Calendar, which is every morning.
Oh, she has the beautifulest voice in the entire
Doesn't
world.
Doesn't she?
Really ought to be doing radio so she can make some money.
Well,
she and Davina.
I'd
like to train you both for free.
My cousin Jackie Lovelock's birthday is today.
What's a nice name?
Joy Grandison. I don't know if people say, you see, Valentine's Day is a hell of a thing. Darren Smith, Yasmin Aird. Yeah, it's 7 months. It's also Rasheed. I'm coming, I soon find it. Andrea, my classmate, Andrea Harrow Walters. Her son Rasheed's birthday is today.
Harrow Walters?
She's Harrow Walters.
Yes,
she didn't name Harrow, but she changed it to Walters. I mean, they are trying to find it and can't find it.
Hey.
But in between time, birthday greetings to a great dad, Mr. Derek Young. Aubrey, gimme.
From daughter to Aubrey, you draw this or you write this?
Never know. Aubrey was a medical doctor.
Birthday greetings to a great dad, Mr. Derek Young, from your daughter Teresa, the rest of the family and friends. God bless you and enjoy your special day. Lots of love. So that's Derek Young from your daughter Teresa.
All right.
Rest of the family and friends. Why that's a dog?
Because I have a protective screen panic. Marvin has tried to make a put on my phone. So that's Rasheed Walters from his mom, Andrea Harrow Walters.
It's true. Marvin back is very bad. Mm. Literally and figuratively. So we're good to go. All right.
Me know me not telling a lie for Marvin.
So today, number 28.
Tax amnesty, come back in better go free up in the morning. We'll make the dream become a